It's been 3 years since Rihanna released a brand new album, and this new titled album called Anti has fans going bonkers crazy to find out when is the release date. Let's talk about why is it taking Rihanna such a long time to release this A studio album on this episode of Vega 411.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Yeah. Pull out a dub. It's Fergie.
Hey guys, on a new episode of Vega 411, I'm excited to talk about this amazing topic because just last week, a lot of fans, mostly the Rihanna Navy, is going bonkers over this long-awaited album called the Anti album. So as you may know, it's been 3 years since Rihanna released her last album, the Unapologetic album. And for some reason, for 3 years of Rihanna taking such a long time off, you wonder, why is it taking her such a long time to even release an album? You may know that Rihanna's the type of artist where when she first started off in the scene, she started doing like R&B type of pop music, and then she got with Jay-Z, and then all of a sudden her whole career just skyrocketed, and she started releasing a lot of dance jams and pop music. But as of now, for the first time ever, this is very unlikely for Rihanna to really take a long time, especially 3 years. The longest that Rihanna has ever taken away from an album was at least a year and a half to 2 years. But this has been the longest time that Rihanna has released an album, 3 years. So fans are wondering, why is it taking Rihanna so long? Or maybe it's because since, you know, her direction of the album didn't go the way she wanted to, because she previously released a lot of these promo singles like Bitch Better Have My Money, and then she released American Oxygen, and also a couple of other promo singles, which in my opinion, I'm not really for it, because I'm not really a big fan of the promo singles that she's been releasing. And I'm like, but why is she releasing these type of hip hop and rap type of songs? Now, of course, she can give it in that type of genre, but I think in this day and age of music, since she's been around for about, gonna be like already, it's already 10 years now, because she started to be in the scene since 2006 2005, but this new type of sound, I'm not really feeling Rihanna doing this, like American Oxygen and Bitch Better Have My Money and 4 or 5 seconds, which in reality only took her 4 or 5 seconds to even start off doing that damn single, because honestly, it's been amazing that in every album, she's always had a number one hit single, and she has been having the most number one singles behind Mariah Carey. And a lot of people are kind of a little bit like, wow, that's amazing, because she is a single artist and her albums don't really sell, but due to the fact that her singles do sell, that's why her albums sell alongside of it, because it also helps her promote her album due to her great singles. But then again, I'm just kind of a little bit not feeling this new type of style that Rihanna's doing, like the 4 or 5 seconds American Oxygen and all that. Like these promo singles, like why release these singles to talk about, oh, you're releasing an album, you're releasing an album, and there's no album coming out. So what was the whole point, to have fans waiting? Now, this is what I feel. If Rihanna really wants to release a new album for her fans, you guys already know Rihanna's not an album seller. The only reason why her albums do sell is because her singles are the reason why a lot of people are gravitating to these singles, because she does a lot of pop and dance music, and she promotes a lot, like at the Grammys and the VMAs and the AMAs, which help her boost the ratings. Now I'm kind of a little bit on the fence. Would Rihanna release a new album and manage to get a number one album? Yes and no. Depending on how she's gonna release the album. If she decides to release the album in 2016, she may, I don't know, it's a hit or miss. You know, I think that the record label, as well as her doing an endorsement deal with Samsung, as you see, she's been doing like this promo countdown to help her promote her album, and her tour is gonna happen in February. And just last week she was at the Met Ball and she said that she's gonna release an album soon, and everybody's like, oh my god, soon, when is it gonna happen? Rihanna, if you're gonna decide to release this album and even the record label, release it the right way. Don't just simultaneously say, oh, because a lot of artists decided to surprise an album on iTunes, just like Beyonce did with her Beyonce album, doesn't necessarily mean that it's gonna work for you, baby girl. So I suggest that since you know that your streams are singles and your last album did become the only number one album that sold high sellings out of all your discography, I mean, look at all her accolades. I mean, I can read you all the accolades that Rihanna has been doing. 200 million records sold since 2015. That is a lot for an artist who's been in the game for 10 years to sell a lot of records. Over 33 million albums worldwide. So it goes to show that her records are the ones that are really gravitating and a lot of fans are really liking your music, Rihanna. So start off with the records. Give the records some leeway to really engage to your audience. Don't just throw an album, because you know that the album is gonna be hit or miss, especially the way Adele's out. I don't know, I mean, that's my opinion, how I feel about it. And a lot of fans are kind of a little impatient, but honestly, the best way to wait for a great album is patience. So we'll see, I'm not too sure. But honestly, her last album wasn't doing it for me. I really want Rihanna to really go in there with the beats. I want to hear some great dance club tracks. Stay away from that R&B hip hop, because I don't think people are really caring about it, since, you know, you tried it with the promo singles and it's not working. And I think a lot of fans want to see that dance, loud type of music, like from the Loud album, as well as the Good Girl Gone Bad. Mix the R&B and hip hop. That's what I think you should do, Rihanna. But I honestly think she should release in 2016. Don't release it this year, because we're coming to a close. That's my own opinion. You sound off. Do you think Rihanna should release an album for the holidays? Or do you think she should release it in February, around the time she can promote the tour? Sound off below. And this is an episode of Vega 411. What's going on? See you guys soon.